I'm here with Morgan Vawter, Chief Analytics Director of Caterpillar. Morgan, how are you doing today?
Great. It's been a fantastic event. Really good turnout, great speakers, lots of smart people here. So it's been a really good event.
Fantastic. So you were speaking this morning, a couple hours ago on a keynote. Can you tell us a little bit about what you went to stage and what you were kind of trying to communicate to the audience, really?
Yeah. So I spoke a little bit about Caterpillar, why we care about analytics, how it's making an impact for our customers, for our dealers, and then for our business units, and really some examples of case studies that we've scaled and seen a lot of value from and how we've built that foundation to realize that value. So
great. So obviously Caterpillar is working a lot in, I mean, I don't know the full extent of your guys' industries, but obviously you're working a lot in heavy industry and all sorts of stuff. So what can you tell, obviously there might be a bit of overlap there with like IoT sensors and all sorts of different technologies. Like where does AI fit really and within what you're up to?
Sure. Caterpillar's very large and has a diverse set of customers, to your point. So we work with customers in construction and mining and oil and gas and all kinds of energy and transportation industries, and serve a number of different customers all around the globe. And connected asset data or IoT data is really foundational to us understanding how our customers are using our machines and ultimately how they're performing on their job site. And so we use all of that data to really understand that usage of the asset, but also to make our customers more productive, safer, and ultimately more profitable. So it's really foundational to that is the data that we get off the assets themselves.
Sure. So obviously, you know, you've been involved in deploying a lot of this technology, but you know, what kind of advice would you give to other enterprises that are looking to actually just get started with this and start making something useful out of this technology?
Yeah, I'd say definitely prioritize the use cases. So make sure that you understand where the biggest pool of value is. If you're doing something from a customer, obviously start from the customer first. You can build the best technology, but if the customer's not ready to adopt it, you're not going to see a lot of value from it. The same applies to your business units and your stakeholders. So again, focus on that adoption readiness and that change management aspect. And then the third thing I'll say is, it's great to do a use case or a set of use cases, but you really need to focus on building a strong foundation for analytics and AI. So investing in the data management, investing in the leadership alignment, investing in the talent, and making sure that you have the tools to really access and use all that data.
For you personally, what is it that draws you to analytics and you know, makes you excited about it?
Yeah, well, it's been a passion of mine since really early on in my life. My dad was a systems engineer and at a really early computing company, and so he's been my mentor and kind of my guiding light in here in this path, and that's really been shaping my passion for the space. But I think the thing about analytics that I love is it really helps transform all aspects of how we do business, and there's so much potential. It's the same way the internet was, 20 plus years ago. Analytics has that potential to be that transformative and that exponential. And so I love seeing that change, seeing that increase in efficiency, seeing those insights or that decision that's being made correctly that before was being made based on instinct. I just love seeing the impact that we can have. Yeah.
So what are some of the like key challenges you think have arisen just in your personal experience around all this?
Yeah. So I think the big ones are, talent, tools and technology, and culture. And so obviously talent, there's less data scientists than there are roles to fill. So we have a shortage there. And then the retention of those talented resources is really difficult. And then the second thing I think is the tools and technology. And so a lot of times there are use cases that you want to adopt and the data or the technology and the tools aren't ready. And then the third thing I think is culture. So it's hard for people to change the way they act and the way they do business. And so getting to overcome some of those cultural aspects is another big barrier, I think, across industries.
So, looking forward to the future, what kind of your priorities in the next year or so for just, moving your analytics practices forward and, kind of building new results and all sorts of things?
Yeah, sure. So I think definitely scaling the value and making sure that we're getting the most value out of the existing analytics solutions that we have. And then second is making sure that we're really enabling our customers' business in a bigger way and making it really easy for them to use. They don't need to know that there's an analytics solution behind the scenes that's helping to make them more efficient, but we want to make sure we're driving the most value we can for them out of their investment in us and working with us as a company.
Great. Well, Morgan, thanks for talking to me today.
Yeah.